There's no doubt about it. With more than 3,600 square feet of living space between the main house and its spacious studio workshop building, this is a beautiful and serene home here in the foothills of the Sierra Nevada mountains. We'll come back and take a closer look at the various buildings on this property in just a few moments. But first, let's explore some of the many gifts of nature that surround you here. After you step out onto the huge deck and stroll down a little path past the studio workshop and discover one of the most strikingly beautiful waterfalls in all of Nevada County. When we decided to escape from the hurly-burly of the San Francisco Bay Area, we were looking for a place of serenity, beauty, and openness, near a town with a vibrant, ecological, cosmopolitan culture. That's when we chose to move to the delightful National Historic Site and hip community of Nevada City. I was looking for silence and a place with a distant view, while my wife insisted upon our finding a home near the sound of running water. Now, in the foothills of California, it's nearly impossible to find a place with a view that's also quiet and near a town with all its traffic and people noise. What's more, in the foothills, water flows only in deep canyons, far from high points with a view. The task of finding such a place seemed impossible. But after 2 years of searching and holding that vision, we found this gem located on beautiful Rock Creek. Cool Rock Creek, because its water is snowmelt, coming from the melting snows in the Sierra Nevada mountains that flow over a lava cap to emerge crystal clear and cold just a little ways up the road. When I first found this place, I could hear the sound of the creek up at the house, but it was only after chainsawing my way through 100 years' growth of brush and bush that I emerged in the face of this literally awesome sight, and I knew this was the place for me. Right in my backyard, a waterfall so beautiful, you'll think you're in a national park. In fact, we call this portion of the waterfall Little Yosemite. And as for the distant view, lovely in every season. And wonder of wonders, you can't hear any neighbors. This place has it all. Imagine, every morning you can go on a long, undisturbed walk on leaf-strewn pathways through this unfolding tableau of living splendor, through fields and mesas, views of distant ridges, a beautiful mixed forest of giant ponderosa pines and incense cedars poking up through the canopy of mountain oak, live oak, and the most beautiful madrones you'll ever find. And gloriously fragrant walkways alongside the more than 1,000 feet of private creek that runs through the center of it all. And you can do all of this without ever having to set foot off the property, pausing at convenient rest stops and viewpoints at strategic spots of exceptional beauty along the way, enjoying the healing sound of flowing water, abundant, beautiful native wildlife, the birds, squirrels, deer, foxes, turkeys, Indeed, every season is beautiful here, even the winter, especially on those occasions when you awaken to the utter silence of a few inches of snow. Just enough to grace the landscape and make it more beautiful for a day. Most friendly snow I've ever seen, because it starts to melt when the sun comes out, transforming into a beautiful shower of clumps and flakes of sparkling snow. And magically, by the next morning or afternoon, it's pretty much melted away in the sunshine. And less than a mile's walk or drive up the road is beautiful Round Mountain State Park, with its wildflowers and views of mountain ridges and valleys extending into the distance. And there's usually no one else there, a perfect place for many a sunset toast. During our first decade of living here, I carved out a vast network of trails, passing through a variety of climatic zones. And it's possible to go for about an hour's walk without ever retracing your steps. And the trails are just as great for jogging or working out as they are for walking, riding your mountain bike, or ATV, or your horse. It's great exercise. And it can take you to beautifully secluded places for, perhaps, a private conversation or two, or for meditation. In fact, one of my favorite places to think or meditate is Serenity Point, located at the tip of Rock Ridge, where the creek is more of a whisper in the distance, a place of true solitude and silence. You won't be bothered here, looking down on the granite rocks and Eagle Rock, with the creek located just beyond. Ah, the creek, with its changing moods and seasons, is where you'll probably choose to spend a good deal of your time. We'll come back and explore the creek and its waterfalls in a little while, but for now, let's go up and check out the house, the studio, and the other structures. Just to our left, before we enter the front gate, is the large meadow which our home looks out upon. Entering through the flower garden and the front door into this first building, which is 1,800 square feet and features the living room, where half the vaulted ceiling is made of skylight windows, and the stove we like to use for that delicious wood heat in the winter. The breakfast area, looking out on the huge 900 square foot deck, which is shaded by deciduous oaks, so it's cooler in the summer and sunny in the winter. The dining room, and the TV room. Upstairs, we have the landing area of the balcony, the master bedroom with its own private deck, looking around the corner at the main deck below, the guest room, and the huge fenced and terraced vegetable garden out back. Now let's head over to the studio workshop building, a few steps away, with more than 2,700 square feet of usable space. This very solid building is constructed of 2x6 closely spaced lumber because it was designed as a music and dance studio and needed to be quiet and solid. The music studio portion of it measures 20 feet by 30 feet, with two walls of windows looking out onto the large deck, where you'll find the steps leading up from the downstairs guest room, and a beautiful little private rainforest of moss and stones. A wonderful place for contemplation and creativity. Then there's the large room, measuring 40 feet by 30 feet. And the wraparound deck. Now, let's take a quick look downstairs. At the guest room and the auxiliary room, and traveling up the driveway a ways to the barn area, tractor shed, and livestock area. This property was once a breeding ranch for Arabian horses. And now on to the 900 square foot two-bedroom cottage. With its sunroom greenhouse out back. And the riding arena that also doubles as a play area. Next, we drive up to the top of the property where there are currently two modular units. And that wonderful view. What do you say we finish up with another little trip down to the creek, to what is almost everybody's favorite spot? The place by the swimming hole where we go to picnic or camp out and gaze up at that magnificent 100 feet of cascading waterfalls. There's a trail up the left side of the creek, so you can walk up to the very head of the waterfall, which is quite exciting, especially in the winter or after a rainstorm. Walking down the creek from the camping area, we soon arrive at this long stretch of rapids flowing over a base of gray granite and pink feldspar. Still further downstream, you get to another private area next to the creek. I could go on all day with all the special areas of this property and how much we've enjoyed it. Suffice it to say, it is secluded, private, and beautiful. A spectacular location for the house and estate of your dreams. Home for a large family or a group of friends, a campground, and so forth. Your imagination is the only limit. We hope you've enjoyed this quickie tour of the Rock Ridge Ranch and urge you to spend some time getting to know the place. Perhaps you will love it as much as we do.